हेलो गाइज वेलकम बैक टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल नीनो एम मशीन अड़ो चूस कदा ये सम राइडिंग कावासाकी H2 फास्टेस्ट मोटर साइकिल इन द वर्ल्ड अंड मन मुंदुन्नदी ट्रायंफ रॉकेट 3 नीन इप्पुडु ढिल्ली लो उन्नानु ఈ బైక్ XBHP మోస్ట్ ఆఫ్ ద పీపుల్ నో హిమ్ హీ సన్నీ వెల్ నోన్ యాజ్ మోటోగ్రాఫర్ మేము యాక్చువల్లీ ఒక షూట్కి వెళ్తున్నాము ఈ కావాసాకి H2 BHP వచ్చేసి 230 అండ్ దీని వెయిట్ వచ్చేసి 240 kgs చాలా అంటే చాలా పవర్ఫుల్ మెషిన్ ఇది ఇది ఫాస్టెస్ట్ స్ట్రీట్ లీగల్ మోటార్ సైకిల్ ఇన్ ద వరల్డ్ H2R అని ఉంటుంది H2R 2 1 కాదు H2R 310 HP బట్ అది స్ట్రీట్ లీగల్ కాదు అది ఓన్లీ ట్రాక్ పర్పస్కి యూజ్ చేసేది అది మన ఇండియాలో ఒకటే ఉంది ఈ H2లో నాకు అన్నిటికంటే నచ్చింది ఏంటో చెప్పాలా ఇది సూపర్ చార్జ్డ్ మెషిన్ కదా దీనికి ఒక ఫ్లటర్ సౌండ్ వస్తుంది చూడండి అది ఐ లవ్ దాట్ అయ్యయ్యో ఆ విజిల్స్ వస్తాయి ఎంత బాగుంటాయి అవి అయితే
against the world round and round I'm caught up in this swirl trying to dig and trying to burrow pressure turned this stone into a pearl lessons that I learned weren't always thorough sugar coated like a churl now I'm really out here on my own now my homies acting like I owe them done extending out my arm made a lot of money from my poems been around and now they say I'm on I can finally say I'm up now 20,000 on a bus down a bus down
ఇంకా దీని విషయానికి వస్తే చాలా 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 రేర్ మెషిన్ అండ్ ఈక్వలీ చాలా పవర్ఫుల్ మెషిన్ కూడా ఈరోజు నేనున్నది ఢిల్లీలో ఒక బ్యూటిఫుల్ లొకేషన్లో ఈ బైక్ అండ్ ఆ రాకెట్ 3 ఈ రెండు సన్నీ బ్రోవి ఇప్పుడు మేము ఒక బ్యూటిఫుల్ లొకేషన్లో ఉన్నాం ఇక్కడ కొంచెం పైకి వెళ్ళి రేసింగ్ గురించి కానీ అండ్ బైక్స్ గురించి కానీ ఈ వ్లాగ్లో మాట్లాడుకుందాం ఇప్పుడు మేమిద్దరం ఈ మెషిన్ డ్రైవ్ చేయబోతున్నాము వెళ్ళి బైక్స్ నడిపి బైక్స్ గురించి ఇంకా చాలా విషయాలు మాట్లాడేసుకుందాం హీ లుక్ సో కూల్ కదా ఈ బండి నాకు ట్రాక్లో కావాలి అసలు అసలు నేను టాప్ స్పీడ్లో అన్నీ చూడాలి రోడ్ అయిపోయింది అనుకుంటాను. ఐ థింక్ వీ హావ్ టు టేక్ యూ టర్న్ హియర్. ఇక్కడ ఆ మెషిన్ నడుపుదాం. చాలా కంఫర్టబుల్ ఉంది అయితే, అసలు కార్నర్స్లో కూడా లిటరలీ H2 కంటే కంఫర్టబుల్ ఉంది కార్నర్స్లో. ఓ మేబీ టైర్ సైజ్ చాలా పెద్దది కదా. చాలా స్మూత్ ఉంది ఇది, ఎంత హెవీ ఇంజన్ నడుపుతున్న ఫీల్ లేకుండా ఈక్వల్లీ పవర్ఫుల్. ఆఫ్ కోర్స్ 2500 మెషిన్ కదా, 2500 సీసీ మెషిన్ కదా. చాలామందికి తెలుసు అని చాలామంది నాకు ఎప్పటి నుంచో అడుగుతూనే ఉన్నారు H2 గురించి. ఫైనలీ ఐఎమ్ హియర్ అండ్ పక్కనున్న బైక్ ట్రయంఫ్ రాకెట్ 3. ఇంకొక కూలెస్ట్ పర్సన్ ఇక్కడ మనతో ఉన్నారు, హీఈస్ మోటోగ్రాఫర్. ఈ రెండు బైక్స్ డ్రైవ్ చేశాను. ఐ జస్ట్ వాంట్ టు ఆస్ ది ఓనర్ లైక్ ఈ బైక్లో నచ్చింది ఏంటి, నచ్చింది ఏంటి.
సో యు నో లైక్ మెనీ పీపుల్ ఐ థింక్ వెన్ దిస్ కేమ్ అవుట్ దిస్ ఇన్స్టెంట్లీ బికేమ్ ది పోస్టర్ మషీన్ విచ్ ఐ పుట్ అప్ ఆన్ ద వాల్ దట్ ఐ వాంట్ టు హ్యావ్ దిస్ వన్ డే. This is not old, like this came out in 2015. This is the 2017 late model that I have here. And is the world's fastest bike, production motorcycle, road legal. Is the only one which has a supercharger. And Kenan Sofoglu is a Turkish racer, I think 600cc champion, world champion. He did a record like 407 kmph on the H2R version of this on a bridge in Turkey. And talking about this one, the Rocket 3 is the world's largest production capacity motorcycle, 2500cc. This, I'm not a cruiser guy, but you know, you rode this, it's acceleration and it's not bad in corners. And of course, I wanted to have the world's fastest bike and the world's largest capacity bike. We call this the XBHP Ultimate Power Duo. This one is the Mind Ninja, that is what I call it. And this is the Soul Rocket. So this is the name, this is the first time I've given my bikes a name. And I've got them wrapped like golden and black. Very classy combination, very different. This bike was originally red, and that is, of course, it comes in that, you know, classy black chrome. I mean, unlike any other motorcycle out there, and all those silver being in the paint and so many layers and everything. So yeah, it's a dream come true for me, you know, having these two motorcycles in the garage. And I think, like, for example, you want to be the best racer out there, so I can say I have the best motorcycles. That's it. And I'm glad that you rode this, you know, because a racer like you, you know, I mean, you handle machines at a different level. So that's the introduction, and thank you so much for coming all the way from Hyderabad.
Thank you so much.
You know, it was great riding with you. Yeah.
And also, I just want to ask one more thing. When you started XBHP motorcycling community in the year 2001, if I'm not wrong, with a
2003.
Yeah. Okay, so what was the, I mean, expectation, and did you reach that till date? Just please tell me about that. And also in 2010, with the title I the Biker, magazines also came out.
Yeah.
So just can you please share me the journey of your...
So in 2003, I was 23 years old, like the way you are, and right now. And I just made a single web page on my first motorcycle. It was a Pulsar 180. Actually, I got that in 2002. So I just wanted to practice web designing, and slowly the website became very famous, because there was no other website in India which, you know, would allow people to come and share their experiences, not only with the Pulsar, but with, you know, all different kind of bikes. And then I thought that I should rename it to something which, you know, which people would resonate, which is not only about one bike. And that is how XBHP came into being. So it means X amount of brake horsepower. It also means like, you know, extra brake horsepower. So slowly, you know, as I grew in age, you know, the XBHP also grew, and we became mature, and, you know, a lot of people kept joining in. In 2008, the website was hacked. So I started again from zero. I just had the name .com, XBHP.com, nothing else, all the members gone. So a lot of people did not return. You know, obviously they were very angry. And here we are right now. Today, you know, I'm very glad, I'm very happy that something, you know, I've given back to the community. In fact, I'm not done yet. I would say to your question that I still have to do a lot of things. I have to get my focus back again to giving back the to the community as much as I can, because today there are a lot of other, you know, things, distractions, which was not there, you know, like peer pressure on social media. What is that person doing on social media? Or because of that person, you know, other people also start doing something. So that kind of pressure was not there. It was a much more free, clean environment. Today, people are not using, I think, social media in the correct way. Some people are using it. Some people are showing high speed chases. XBHP was like a river, you know, it went wherever it went. And sometimes I gave it direction, sometimes other people gave it direction. But I think the future lies with people like you, not only for XBHP, I mean generally about motorcycling. If you, for example, win the national championship, if you win ARCC or some, you know, MSBK or whatever, people will start listening to you. They will start, you know, believing what you say. So I think on you lies a lot of weight as far as racing is concerned. On me, I will try to see how, you know, I can evolve myself, XBHP. Still a lot of work to do. And that's about it. Like on the way, we did many more things. Like we did 60 countries on motorcycles, and we just completed Delhi to Singapore. And, you know, we also came out, for example, with this helmet with Axor. We've always been about riding safe. We used to ride with riding gears back 14 years ago when there were no riding gears. And I mean, that's it. I'm talking to a person who was 6 years old when I started XBHP. So it means I must be doing something right, you know, I'm still here. And, you know, I ride safe, I try to ride safe on the road. Does not mean that I don't enjoy, I don't ride hard. It's just that I ride safe, and, you know, you should do also. Don't do stunts unnecessarily, you know, just for YouTube and stuff like that. And it just takes one accident, one thing to change your life. And Sandeep has had many accidents because he was racing, not because he was riding recklessly on the road. There's a difference, you know. That is called sacrifice. That is not called foolishness. And I respect the machines. I respect the opportunity that I have to own these machines. I thank God. and you know it's just like a dream come true. Even now it's like being a video game, you know, selecting which bike to ride every Sunday. So that's it. As long as you keep enjoying what you're doing, I think you're doing the right thing. If you stop enjoying, it doesn't matter. Even if you're the you know, if you have Lamborghini, Ferrari, doesn't matter. Old me's dead and that's gone, thank God I'm headstrong. I don't wanna wake up in a doubt that I show them everything I'm about. I ain't never going out, I ain't never did it for no clout. Now I'm sitting early on the clock, my mom's still crap. I'm up now, 20,000 on a bus down, a bus down. I'm on my way up, going up now.